Welcome to our new skateboard park in the city of Wheat Ridge. We have a lot of great new amenities in the city of Wheat Ridge, and this is one new one at 38th and Kipling at Discovery Park. We're here today with adults and children. They're checking out this new skateboard facility. They're using it, and we're here to kick off the grand opening. Let's check it out. 3, 2, 1, here you go.
Thanks for coming out this morning. I'm glad we could all share in this new, fun, exciting amenity for the city of Wheat Ridge.
So this park and the whole planning process started in 2008, so we're finally there. This is phase three of it. So what do you guys think of this new skateboard park in Wheat Ridge?
It's awesome.
We've done some crazy tricks that we couldn't do at our other
park. Our other skate park was whack, but this one's way better.
Just having a bowl like this will get kids to learn how to do it. Like, Anderson doesn't have a bowl, so a lot of kids are gonna start coming here and skating that. It's got the handrails. It's awesome.
Jace, you've done a really great job on this park. Can you kind of give the folks an idea what the process was that we went through?
One of the recommendations in our master plan process that this area was in need of a park. Due to the size of the property, we were able to add a lot more amenities than might originally be included in a neighborhood park. So in 2008, we started our planning process, and we held three public meetings. We hired design concepts to prepare a master plan for the site based on the public input they received. Combining that with the recommendations in the master plan, which was that this would be a great site for a skate park. So, and the next year we put the project out to bid.
Great.
Began construction.
So how's the process been going? Pretty well?
Pretty well. We built the park in really two phases. And we built the first half, started it in 2010, and then started the second phase, which included the skate park, the restroom, some additional landscaping, late 2011. Now we're complete here in 2012.
I know we completed phase one and phase two, and then we were getting phone calls for the last year. Why were we tearing up the park? I kept telling everybody, phase three, it's a skateboard park. So now we're done, right?
We are complete. We are totally complete. Team Payne was our skateboard contractor, and they did a design build for us. And this skate park is really built by skaters, so they skate it, build it, tweak it, and they're really pleased with the outcome. They say it's a great park to skate.
Well, this is the new Wheat Ridge Skate Park. It's right around 14,000 square feet, and Team Payne's involvement in the project was from the beginning. We're a design build company. We designed it and constructed it. It took roughly 10 weeks to build. On any given time, I had 10 crew members on this site, but they're all skateboarders, so they really understand how a skate park should be built.
I just think there's a lot of unusual elements. There's a lot of variety. There's hips and ramps and spines and different types of copings and treatments that I think really make it an attraction. It's a multi-generational park. There's something for everyone. Come out here any day of the week and you'll see kids of all ages, adults enjoying it.
We've went through this whole park and designed it for all skill levels, from beginner all the way up to pro. It's got all elements of skateboarding covered: street skating, transitional bowl skating, plaza style skating. It was actually a pretty fun project to be involved with.
Just the skate park alone, you're talking about 600 or 700 cubic yards of concrete. And then there's probably about 150 to 200 tons of rebar in this concrete.
How much?
200 tons of rebar.
200 tons?
Yes.
That's pretty big.
One of the highlights of this project is right where this bowl is here, we had to dig a hole about 30 feet deep in order to prevent soil from moving and get proper compaction so that the bowl doesn't continue to crack. In just this third phase, you've got 35,000 feet of sod.
So it's my understanding it's about 14,000 square feet.
The park alone, yes. The
park alone, great.
Yes.
We got stairs, gaps, and the great bowl that I love the most.
I think it's awesome. It's really cool. We got a really cool bowl, a lot of cool features. I haven't really checked out the street courts too much, but it looks awesome.
I think it's really nice. I like it. Team Payne, they always build great skate parks, great transitions and everything. I've just been kind of running around the street course, just kind of cruising around.
So, Joe, you were in one of my classes this fall at Wheat Ridge High School. You're not in summer school this, are you?
No.
Good job. See you later.
There was a demand, there was a request from the citizens to have a skate park that was coming on, becoming more and more popular with other cities. It's been packed every day. Rain or shine, there are people playing here. It's amazing.
So today I'm here with Mike Stites. Mike Stites is on City Council District 3. He's been an avid supporter of this park since day one, and it was a major component of all the voting and all of the work that the council did to get this moving forward. So Mike, tell me, how do you think this park in the end, has benefited District 3 and the entire city of Wheat Ridge?
Oh, I think it's great for District 3. I think it brings in young families. I think it brings in older families. And it's a great addition to the park system. You have a lot of amenities here now. And skateboard park, the water features, and I think it's fantastic.
I supported it because it's a good thing for kids. They need to have activities that keep them from just sitting around their house and playing video games. This way they're out and about, they're getting exercise, they're getting sun, they're socializing. You know, it's a really great way for them to be with other people and not kind of be so separate. It brings a community together, and anything that we can do that does that makes us a better place. And anything that draws these many people into one spot, it's a good thing.
It was about 18 months ago or a year ago that we were here doing the grand opening of the park. What do you think of the changes with the new playgrounds and the pavilions and the skateboard park? It looks really, what do you think about it now?
I think it is fantastic. My daughter and her friends come here a lot. I drive by here a lot, and I just am always amazed by the number of people that are here. We just need to have places for people to gather and to have fun, and this is a fantastic example of how you can bring people together.
Well, I've been skating close to 30 years, so it's sort of my passion. I mean, I love building skate parks. It's what I do. I still skate to this day. All my construction workers skate, so they have a strong passion about making it good. They want to make it right because they want to be able to come back and skate it as well. It's just a great feeling to come back and see the kids skating the parks that we built for them.
Yeah, I mean, I skateboard because I love it. It's pretty much my life. It says it right there, skateboard for life. Challenging. I learn something new almost every day. There's always progression.
I think it turned out phenomenally. Better than anyone expected, and everything just came together better than we imagined. And it's really great to see all the people out here.
This skateboard park is going to be used by adults and children all year round. I'm very excited for District 3, for our city of Wheat Ridge, and we're moving forward together with new community amenities for people to live, work, and play in the city of Wheat Ridge. Check out our website at www.ci.wheatridge.co.us for all the great amenities in the city of Wheat Ridge.